Most things in the sitcom haven't happened, but most things in the book have.
Okay, so in the book you relate an incident about when you were in a restaurant, emerged from the ladies with a toilet roll trailing behind you.
Yeah, stuck into my tights.
Did that seriously happen?
Yeah. And why would a really sort of, strong ply loo roll be stuck that would come through the entire restaurant? I look like a sort of loo roll streamer.
And what would you say? So what are you saying to your 18-year-old self? Are you saying it's all right because it's all going to get better? Or have you got sort of remedies for situations where loo roll gets stuck to you?
No, it's mainly saying it's fine and it happens to all of us, I hope. I bet you've had loo roll stuck in the bottom of your trousers before.
Happens.
Okay. Only a matter of time.
Yes.
But yeah, it's mainly saying that as you get older, you gain more confidence and you can deal with it, or it just makes funny dinner party conversations. But it's kind of saying we're all trying to cover up being idiots generally. That's my hope.
Yeah. I have begun the new me. I know. Mum and Tilly won't know what's hit them. I'm going to be the kind of woman who, you know, the kind of woman that just leaps out of bed and just does that. And their hair looks perfect. They then grab a homemade muffin out of their Kath Kits and polka dot biscuit tin and head to work wearing trainers at the bottom of a skirt suit to show off they've power walked in. They have pot plants that don't die on them. Their fruit bowl isn't full of 3-week-old rotting pears because they actually eat the fruit.
One of the things you talk about is, it's a feature, isn't it? Your height.
Yes.
And you get bound up in the situation where you're very open about what people say about your height.
Yeah.
But you're also cross about the fact that people cannot have a conversation with you without mentioning your height, which is exactly the trap I've just fallen into.
No, it's fine, because you're asking me about asking it. So it's fine. You've subverted it, which I like.
Or I've tied myself up in knots.
Yes.
Yeah.
Either way, it's smashing. but... Oh, I forgot what you asked now.
What is it about people's height that makes other people compelled to refer to it?
I think it's because it's seemingly a good thing. You know, height is meant to be to one's advantage.
Right.
So you couldn't go up to someone and say, "You are so small and spherical. How long have you been that? Your parents also really fat?" You couldn't say that.
No.
But you can say to people, when did you start growing? What size are your feet? Where do you get your jeans?
That's right. There are things about other people's physical appearance you would never dream of referring to, even though they were very obvious.
Yeah, I mean, there's so many things I'm trying to stop myself saying about you, Susanna, now, that I couldn't possibly say.
What?
I'm joking.
Come on,
you set me up. It's a joke. You're a beautiful lady. Annoyingly, I can't think of anything. She's perfect.
In every way.
In every way.
And so are you.
Look at your lovely hair.
And yours. Bill?
Anyway. It's suggested that people think you're making a film about Miranda.
Well, it's a very exciting notion. I think the press know more about it than I do. Mm. I would love the opportunity to do that, but whether it's going to happen, I don't know.
And since you're the central person involved, you should know.
I should really know, yes.
Right. Are they making a film?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I had one meeting about it, and it was a sort of thinking about whether what could happen and whether it would be an option. So, I mean, I love the idea about it, but I don't know, to be honest.